Every Power BI beginner must know these three kinds of merge in Power Query. The first one is a regular merge, which most users know. But today we're going to cover the range merge. And the third merge that you must know is the self merge. So let's focus on the range merge and what is this about. Let's start with a regular merge. So regular merge simply matches one column with another. And in this case, we want to match maybe the student ID in the enrollment table with the student ID in the student table. And that'll let us get, say, the student's name. And this merge is, of course, really easy to do it in Power BI. You just open the merge in Power Query and select the student ID column on both tables. But a range merge is very different. In this case, we have evaluation, course evaluation on the left side and enrollment data. And what we want to do is take the course evaluation date, let's say September 28th, and merge it or match it with the enrollment, but we have to find the range within which this evaluation date fits. And we can see as a human that yes, September 28th is between the start date of August 15th and October 10th. But there's no combination in the Power Query merge window. There's no two columns that you can select because again, it is not an exact match. We're trying to match a value to see which range it fits into, and that is your range merge. There are lots of scenarios in which you may find yourself needing the range merge. Of course, we saw the date. You're trying to match a date to a date range, and that can happen in a lot of scenarios. Sometimes you're matching a price or a value to a range. In other cases, you're maybe matching a score. It could be a customer score or something else to a score range, and many more such scenarios. Range merge is far more common than you would think. In this video, I'm going to take you step by step through the range merge. So that's coming later in this video. Now, if you're interested to also learn the third kind of merge, which is the self merge, just comment self merge below and I'll send you the self merge tutorial so you can master all three Power Query merges that every beginner should know. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I have helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports in under 30 days. This question was sent to me on LinkedIn, and I love answering Power BI questions, so you can message me on LinkedIn at any time if you need any kind of help. You can also email me at avi@avisingh.com. So let me walk you through the problem in a little more detail. And again, this video is about understanding that core concept of how to do a range merge. The data in this case is about course student evaluation, but once you understand the range merge, you can do that for your own business data. So in this case, we have a student table, which is pretty simple. So student ID, their name and other information. We have course table, which course and the course name and so forth. And then we have an enrollment table. So these two, if you understand the data modeling concepts, if you've gone through our videos on that, then you understand that student and course table are the lookup table and enrollment table is a data table. So this has student ID, course ID, and a start date and end date. And then finally, we have the evaluation table, and this is where we need the range merge. So in this case, we have the student ID, we have the course rating, but we do not have the course ID. And our objective in this case, your mission, if you choose to accept it, is to take this course evaluation date and match it against the enrollment table. So find the range where this student was enrolled in the course, and then we would know that, oh, this evaluation is for course 102. Now, to make things simple for this example, we can assume that a given student is only enrolled in one course at a time. Of course, in real business scenarios, you might have other scenarios, but for this one, we're gonna keep it nice and simple just so you can understand the concept of range merge. So let's see how we can solve this in Power BI. And by the way, if you wanna download the files, the data files in this Power BI file, just go to this URL and you can download and follow along with this video or try this yourself later on. So we're gonna click the transform data button to step into the kitchen of Power BI, which is Power Query. I'm gonna ignore this table, it's already there. So I'm gonna say new source Excel workbook, and I point it to my source file here, and we'll simply select all the tables in here and click OK. Our tables are loaded in Power Query, and remember, it's the evaluation table which we're trying to solve. So we don't have the course ID. We're going to take the course evaluation date, match it against the enrollment data using a ranged merge, and figure out which course this is. So let's get started. So we are going to start by clicking the merge button right here, and we will select the enrollment table. But this is gonna feel a little bit weird to you, because notice what we're gonna do here. We're gonna match the student with the student ID. So we have some information available. So we're not doing anything with the dates right now, but we have the student ID here. So we're gonna match with those. But watch what happens here. Now, you can probably notice in the background that we have 20 rows of data here. But I'm gonna hit OK. And I'll have this table, and I'm gonna expand or blow it up. And when I expand it, what I'm looking for is really the course ID and the start date and the end date. And I'm gonna uncheck this use original column, hit OK, but notice what happened here. We went from 20 to 40 rows. And really, depending on your data, what's gonna happen, and that's why I use the word blow up, it's gonna blow up your table. Now again, this is very unusual for merge, because generally, and when you're doing a merge, you actually wanna be very sure that your number of rows don't go up. Usually we're doing in a regular merge, we're doing a left merge, so the number of rows stays the same. And it's a problem. It can be something, a red flag if the number of rows increases. But in this case, the range merge, we're doing this intentionally, and then we're gonna take more steps to reduce the number of rows again. Now, what this has done is this has matched essentially every row in here. So if one student, 1001, was enrolled in this case in two courses, it took that one row and it matched it with both courses. And it took the second row and matched it with both courses. And that's why we have ended up with four rows. So you can see here, and now our job is simply to filter down and only keep the rows that make sense. For example, if you look at the first one here, and we look at this, we can see that the course evaluation date, 9/28, is indeed between this. So this one is good. We'll keep this row. This is the one that we want. If you look at the next record, we can see that the course evaluation date is outside of this range. So we're not gonna keep this row and remove it. And we're gonna do the same for all of these. And of course, the way we're gonna do it is simply adding a custom column. So we're gonna add a custom column, click on this here, and we'll say matched. And we're gonna say the course evaluation date has to be greater than or equal to the start date. And the course evaluation date is less than equal to the end date. So it's between those, if that is true. I missed saying if. So if this is true, then we're gonna say, yep, it's a match. Else we're gonna say false, it's not a match. Hit okay, and we have that column. And all we have to do is click here and only keep the true rows, which truly matched. And notice we're back to the original number of rows, because we only kept the rows that made sense, that were valid. So we're back to the original number of rows, 20 rows. And this is what I love about being in the kitchen of Power BI, because it's got the trash can. We can throw away the banana peels. We don't need that. I don't eat banana peels. I hope you don't either. I don't know if they're nutritious. Maybe they are. Don't eat banana peels. So yeah, so these are the banana peels, start date, end date, and matched. We don't need that information. All we really cared about is to get the course ID. So now that we have it, let's load it up into Power BI and build the data model. So I'm gonna hit close and apply and load it to our model. And let's go to the model view, and we're gonna clean this up, ignore this. So again, as I had mentioned at the beginning, you gotta know your hippos and giraffes, which is your lookup tables and data tables. So the course is a lookup table. These are the hippos, And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, ask me for the data modeling beginner's guide. Just comment the word guide below and we'll send that to you. It's geared for beginners, and data modeling is a core concept in Power BI that every beginner must know and master. So the evaluation and enrollment are data tables. But again, earlier the enrollment one did not have a course ID, and using the range merge, we now have a course ID so we can make that connection between this and the course table. I'm sure you enjoyed learning about the range merge, and if you're curious about the self merge, then again, just comment self merge below and I'll send you that tutorial. Take care and power on.